Hi, this is Lynn from WisconsinGarden.com. Now earlier we started our mushroom kit and it said to keep checking it for the next week or so to make sure that the mycelium is growing, and when it gets to 30 to 40%, then it has to go into the basement in a darker place. Right now it's been sitting in the dining room where it's in the 70s. So let's take a peek at it and see how it's progressing. All right, for those of you that saw the original one, this is a kit that has a bag that has compost in the bottom that has been impregnated with the mushroom spores. On the top, we put a layer of crushed limestone, sphagnum moss, and what was the third thing, Rick?
Was it a crushed limestone?
Crushed limestone, sphagnum moss, and one other thing.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. Moss,
But anyway, that's where the mushrooms will be growing. So what we're looking for now is this white fuzzy area. And when that gets to be 30 to 40% covered on here, which it's coming along, you can see the shadow of the mycelium, which is the mushroom growing. And you can even see, if you look down, that little white, those little white spots, those will turn into the white button mushrooms right there. It's not quite ready yet, maybe another day, and then it'll go downstairs where they will sprout up.
Well, we'll keep you updated.
We will. Yesterday when we looked at the mushroom kit, we were looking to see whether the mycelia was 30 to 40% over the cover, over the top. Now, I'm looking at it today, and it's way more than that now. You can see it everywhere almost, except for right in the very middle. So the procedure now is to roll down the plastic so that it's exposed to the air. Do a little test to see how moist it is, because this is how moist I need it to stay all the while it's producing. So there's enough to make my fingers a little wet, and I've just washed my hands, so I'm not adding anything to it. And now it's going to be put downstairs where the temperature is lower. It's probably, what, 60 degrees down there, Rick?
Yeah, plus, you know, in this part of the country, we have basements.
Right.
In parts of the country where you don't, you need to find a dark room or a closet or someplace where it's cool.
Right.
That it can
and
start
dark.
Maturing and dark.
Right. Yeah. And once it gets down there in the dark, in the coolness, all of a sudden the mushrooms will be triggered to start growing. And that's the exciting part. Then you have to check every single day. This has been 1 week now since we put the kit together, and I'm very pleased. It's very active.
Yes, it is.
Very
especially
active.
Along the
right,
the
you'll
purple.
Notice along the edges where it's probably a little more
moist.
Damp. Mm-hmm. Now, the way you water it is you take a plastic or a paper cup, perhaps, or if you've got a sprinkler bottle, and you just kind of sprinkle it on every 2 or 3 days. Not making it mushy. You don't want mush. You just want it to stay moist.
So you could take a little paper cup, take a needle, poke some holes in the bottom.
Yes.
And then take your water from a glass or something, pour it into the paper cup.
Yes.
Kind of let it dribble.
Mm-hmm. Yes. You just want it to dribble. Or you could use a spray bottle and just spray it.
Yeah,
so that
that's another one. Yeah.
You know, you see that the top is moist. Down here in the bottom, it's moist. You can see all of my mycelium down there.
Wow.
Yeah. So that's what's going to be coming up, and that's what we're going to be eating.
And harvesting, and boy,
yes.
Are those good.
Mm-hmm.
I mean,
and
to
drying.
Eat fresh mushrooms.
And they're just so cute.
Yeah. You know, kids are just amazed when they see how quickly this happens.
Yes.
So, you know, again, a great family project to work on,
right.
Getting a mushroom kit.
Exactly. And when kids see it, you know, because they've all seen mushrooms outside, and we always say, don't eat those, don't touch those, don't eat those. But when it's in their own home and you know where it's come from, it's magical for them, and especially that they can now take a bite of them.
Well, not only that, but they know how to harvest and pick them,
yes,
and then take them up into the kitchen or wherever, and
right,
actually
them
prepare
off,
them,
right,
and again, them hide them in cookies and bread and all kinds, mm-hmm, of neat ways of getting mushrooms into the bellies of children.
Exactly. Hi, this is Lynn from WisconsinGarden.com, and we are about to take a look at our mushrooms again, as we had a couple of days ago, when everything was fine. And then we looked, and there was a gray mold that seemed to be growing on the surface, in addition to the mycelium that is supposed to be there. So this, the white is the good growth. The gray, fuzzy area is not good growth. Upon contacting the company, they told us there are so many different kinds of molds that are flying around in the air anyway, that they weren't sure what kind it was, and that if we were up to it, we should just scrape off the parts that we did not like, which would set the mycelium back for maybe a week or so, and then see how things started growing. So we're about to do the scraping. You can see that the mushrooms are forming anyway in areas where the gray mold is not. These all will be button mushrooms, and if we let them grow longer, then they'll turn into creminis and then portobellas. I mean, we have had mushrooms this large forming on other boxes of mushrooms.
Well, we've had other kits from this company, mm-hmm, and we've never had a mold issue like we did this time. And
right,
you've sterilized everything and
yes,
followed the directions like you normally do.
Mm-hmm. And they were very helpful. They said if that didn't do the trick, that we should just, you know, they will replace it. So what I'm doing is I'm just going to take off this top layer here. And I purposely kept it a little drier in here after I saw that it was turning moldy, but I can see now that it's just way too dry. So after I get done scraping, I am going to do a little sprinkling. Now, I'm not afraid that I'm ruining my crop of mushrooms, because if you would look at the side of the bag, you could see that the mycelium goes all the way to the bottom. So it will be coming back.
Yeah, it's all along the edge and bottom, so it'll be growing upwards.
I think I'll take some out of here.
It's amazing the odoriferous,
mm-hmm, smells good.
Smell, it has
like
a very
earth,
mushroom, earthy smell to it.
Look how big this one is already.
There's a little bit over there too, I see.
Yep.
On that side.
You can see how the mushrooms grow through the soil. Okay, what do you think about that? I think I got most of it. My hands are clean.
Does it always stay in the box?
Does what always?
Do you transplant that after X amount of time?
No, it seems to, they seem to run their course after they've gone through a couple of blooms for about, they said anywhere from 60 to 90 days, then they kind of peter out, so. Then I've just taken it and dumped it into the compost pile, which was mm-hmm, fine. There, what do you think of that? How does that look?
Yep, it looks pretty good.
Okay. Well, now I've got my little sprinkling can here. Bought at the, I think at the dollar store.
Yep.
Okay, and then we'll put this back downstairs in the dark. And I bet in a day or so that one will be ready to eat.
So we'll continue to keep an eye on it, and mm-hmm. we'll just add some more updates as the mushrooms develop.
Right.
You're going to show any of your delicious mushroom recipes in the process as well?
Yes, I will.
Do I get some with my eggs and bacon in the morning?
If you'd like it.
Okay.
It's been about 3 days now since we scraped off the moldy part that we were concerned about, and we followed the directions from the seller, and he said that part will probably take a little bit longer than to produce any mushrooms, but you can see the rest of it is doing fantastically. Needs a little water, so I'm going to sprinkle a little water on here.
Well, that's how it normally turns out.
Right.
Like we said, rarely, well, we've never had a mold issue prior to this particular kit. All the kits have always been really good.
Yes.
And very productive.
Yes. And you can see this one is done. I mean, we can eat this one. And the way you pick it is you push down and you turn it a little bit. What I'm trying to do is unhook it from the rest. There you go.
So it's like a little knob on a radio.
Perfect. Right.
Radio.
And you can see it's starting to flake off, which is getting more to the cremini size mushroom. These down here are more like the button mushrooms you would see in the store. I'll pick that one too. Let's see if I can break it off here. There we go. Okay, so now I'll just cut that part off, and the rest we eat. Woo.
Yeah. Go ahead.
Every day we have to check it because they can double in size overnight. That's a really cool stuff about mushrooms. So back to the basement it goes, and we'll be really happy. So if you enjoyed watching our progress on this mushroom kit, give us a thumbs up, and we'd love to hear from you with comments or tips or questions, and we would really like to have you subscribe to us. Become part of our garden family.
Now, if somebody else grows a mushroom kit, we'd like to hear from them as well.
Yes, definitely. And you people who live in the Milwaukee area, remember you can get one from this very farm, the River Valley Ranch, at the Saturday morning farmers market, the indoor farmers market at the Mitchell Domes. It's gotten so popular now, they have expanded out of the dome. First they started in the dome lobby, then they expanded it to the one of the domes. Now they're going to be moving the whole thing next door to a big greenhouse.
Cool.
So it's getting very popular, and these people will be there.
Well, let's see what kind of mushroom recipes you come up with this time.
Mm-hmm.
They smell good.
They do.